Welcome to Shootin' with Jayme and Kenney. This is the Christmas Spectacular. I am your host, Jayme K. I'm very drunk right now. This is Kenny. And
What up?
By how closed his eyes are, you can probably tell that he is extremely high on crocodile right now.
I don't know about crocodile, but marijuana is a good guess.
We have eggnog.
Eggnog!
Eggnog
cheers,
is our best.
Cheers!
And we are drinking eggnog, and we are having beer, and we have Red's Apple Ale. And neither of us have eaten today. This is our first meals of the day.
Yes.
And
alcohol.
Tonight, we have loads and loads of fun planned. We are greeted by Jack Frost over here. Jack Frost was the name of the snowman in the Michael Keaton movie, right?
I think so.
And we have Mrs. Claus.
Lovely lady.
And tonight we're going to be discussing a whole bunch of topics about Christmas. Kenny, he did not have a Christmas at age 6.
Yeah.
Very unfortunate. We talked about that last week on the show when we had Mike Malkovich, or Malkovich. He's a stand-up comic. We had him on the last show as a guest.
Yeah, good
and
old Malkovich.
Tonight, we might have a guest, top secret, on Skype.
We don't know yet. We're checking our resources.
Oh, fuck it. It's Santa Claus. We have Santa Claus.
Yeah, man. We are that gangster to get Santa Claus.
It's true.
From his secret location. Secret location, bro. Like, he doesn't even...
St. Cloud, Florida.
If we're
lucky, retired.
He says if we're lucky enough, he's going to invite us out there, party, you know, do it up, you know.
Do some coke. Cloud.
Yeah, buddy!
Yeah, cracking you!
Woohoo! Yeah.
And, again, we are drinking eggnog, but we also have beautiful Christmas sweaters on. I'm wearing this really obnoxious black Santa sweater, and I've got bells on it. It's been driving me fucking nuts all day, and I really want to commit suicide right now. Kenny, he has a faux sweater on, fake tie, it's nothing but cotton, and it looks very stylish on him. And why don't we get into the topic of the evening? What are you doing for Christmas this year?
Christmas. I plan on spending Christmas with the fams, you know. Like,
The fans at home who are watching
fams,
the show.
Fams.
Yeah, it's one and the same for you.
I guess. Okay, but yeah. Yeah, basically, you got to spend time with family. That's what
of course,
Christmas,
yes.
That's what Christmas is about, you know, like Yuletides and happy givings and stuff like that. Got to be ready to give. I have, like, all my Christmas presents set, like...
What did you get your girlfriend?
Not saying, because she is a avid listener slash watcher slash paying attentioner to podcasts, videos, and stuff involving me. So,
you're going to ruin the segment by not saying what you got her.
I'm keeping this on the hush, but I guarantee you, like, her eyes are going to light up. Like, I'll take a picture, and the next video cast we do, I'll show you guys it, bro. Like, just gotta make
it. Is it a tube full of sperm?
No. It's something that you buy with money. But
you can buy that with money.
Why would I do that when I have my own stuff going on, dude? It's
I don't
just
know.
Like,
you might have...
Man, I will hand her this... If she wants that, but I had her the turkey baster myself, dude, I'd be like...
You should say gobble gobble while you do that.
Like, time to baste.
Baste God.
Oh, but yeah, anyways. Nah, I got my sister's present.
Vibrator.
No.
Oh, no.
No.
That's what I got my sister.
Oh, yeah. Do you have a sister?
A few.
Oh, that's cool. And then, what else? Got my brother's gift. That was not easy.
I feel like it isn't too wise to drink Bud Light Lime, wonderful beer, with a dairy product. But we're doing it. Well, I'm doing it. You don't like Bud Light Lime because you're a puss and you're a racist against Mexicans.
I drink Corona.
I believe that's Cuban.
Mexican.
It's fucking cold in the North Pole tonight.
Yeah, we got our special guest with us tonight.
Get Frosty.
Senor Frosty.
Frosty.
And then
Mrs. Claus. We got a facial earlier this evening.
Yeah. Oh, snap. Uh-oh.
Speaking of Mrs. Claus, why don't we transition into the interview with Mr. Santa Claus?
He can't know she's here.
Oh, no. I definitely plan on...
I didn't tell her. I didn't tell him she's here, dude.
Well, I guess it'll be a surprise for everyone.
No, dude, like, what's she gonna do, bro? Like, dog, she's bugging out.
The rumor, the word on the street, is that Santa Claus likes to watch the Easter Bunny fuck Mrs. Claus while he watches. I'm just throwing that out there.
Yeah, but, like...
The Great Pumpkin has had his way with Mrs. Claus. I mean, she gets around quite a bit.
But those are, like, their BFFs and stuff, dog. Like, I saw her at Lord and Taylor, dude, and, like, she was right there. And I was like, okay.
Was she wearing, like, booty shorts?
No.
Was her ass on display?
She was, like, all professional.
You know what's not hot, but should be, like, hot in the male brain? Like, ass crack. You know, you would think, because, like, tits are attractive, and cleavage is attractive. But when it comes to an ass, you see an ass crack, you're like, oh, that's just silly. Why? Pull up your pants, lady, or man.
I don't know if it's the right type of girl.
No. If someone's wearing shorts, and their shorts are pulled down to the point where you're seeing a line, that is not attractive.
What if it's one of those girls?
Like, if the shorts are being eaten by the ass cheeks, that's one thing. But ass crack? No. There's no ass cleavage. There just isn't.
You can't do it, though.
Why don't we talk to Santa Claus?
Yeah,
Santa Claus. I think we'll do that now. And we have on Skype Santa Claus, the one and only.
Ho, 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 motherfuckers!
Very inappropriate, Santa. What are you up to this holiday season?
Oh, just double checking my Christmas list.
Have you molested any elves?
No, I have not.
Okay, that's cool. Okay, so. The first segment we have for you at this current moment in my head right now that I'm going to go with, okay?
Yeah.
Your naughty list, and who is on it? Who's on your naughty list this year, bro?
All the black people.
Oh, snap. Okay, continue.
No, I'm kidding. On a naughty list, I don't know.
Like,
everybody.
Hey, Santa, you know that they're trying to turn you into a non-white, right?
Yeah, they're trying to turn you into a penguin, dude.
Trying to turn you into a penguin. Or a black man.
Yeah, like what's on Jamie's shirt. Do you ever seen it?
Black Santa Claus.
Look. Yeah.
What?
Santa, I kind of wanted to tell you that we actually have a guest in studio tonight who isn't you. We have your wife right here. And we're going to gangbang her. We're going to run train on her tonight after the show.
We're
fucking your wife.
Mrs. Claus coming in the crib.
No, we'll be the ones coming.
Yeah! Oh, he went! Yeah,
fucking like, your wife!
Look at his face. He ain't ready for it.
Just, I don't know how you like it, but just make sure she shaves for your pleasure.
So you like it, Harry?
He likes it. We're fucking his wife. He's giving us advice.
Yeah,
Santa cuckold.
Yeah, right. Yeah, we got this.
Yeah, more high fives. Woo! Yeah. You could be a department store Santa, but you kind of look perverted-ish with the regular beard. I mean, with the whole outfit.
There you go.
A lot more friendly.
I was watching Criminal Minds.
I wouldn't put my kid on your lap, but, I mean, you could get work, probably. What are you talking about Criminal Minds for? What?
Oh, y'all, dude, hit the beard. It's just a beard that reminded me of the bad guy in Criminal Minds.
He reminds you of
the bad guy in Criminal Minds? Santa Claus.
No, I said the beard, not that one.
When has Santa Claus been a villain?
Hey, whoever says Santa Claus is bad just made the naughty list.
Oh, you fuckhead!
He said Santa Claus is bad. I just said...
I didn't say that. He said he saw you like the villain on Criminal Minds, that you look like him.
Oh, shit.
What about bad...
Don't they
bad
have
Santa?
Sex offenders on that show?
Yeah.
Exactly. What are you saying?
All types of crazy people. Dude, this chicken like mental...
Chicken?
Chicken.
Mentholated chicken?
No, this chicken menthol.
Chicken, what?
Her pheromones. What? Yeah, dude. Menthol, like, the flowers.
Alright, well, Merry Christmas and thank you, fuck you. Boop, 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 boop.
That was my impression of Skype. Fuck you all.
I didn't say anything, dude.
So, that was us with Santa Claus.
It kind of feels nice to pet my black Santa. Can you see this on camera, camera lady, who will go unnamed? You can see my Santa Claus?
Yeah.
It's nice.
You like tugging on his beard?
I do. I do. Now, we did just get done talking to Santa Claus in Florida, who relocated. It's fucking elves, and we have Miss Claus
as a hostage. It's crazy. You think he'd get blacker, but he just got whiter.
In Florida. Yeah. You think he would get a tan, but...
St. Cloud, Florida, yo, like...
Woo!
Okay, that's cool.
Kenny's got a new hairstyle.
Yeah, I do. I like my hairstyle.
It kind of looks like the black lady from Orange is the New Black, Crazy Eyes. Kenny.
Yeah.
You know, on Fox News, there was a lady who got in trouble for saying that Santa Claus was white. And that Jesus was white. But he isn't white. He's more Arabic. I think.
He's Jewish.
If he existed at one point.
He was Jewish, dude.
Yeah, and the Jews were Jewish. Arabic.
And Santa Claus was from England, dude. I don't even know. Yo, you guys got it twisted, son, because, like, you guys forget about Santa Claus as, like, right-hand man, the Krampus.
Krampus. Yeah. No, Krampus is, like, his bizarre... If Santa Claus was Superman, Krampus would be his bizarro. Kenny, I think it's time that we reveal to the audience at home who is on our naughty and nice list for the year.
Okay. How
unenthusiastic. But yes, you may begin with nice, of course. Because naughty is always more interesting. I feel like people who hate other people are always more interesting than people who love other people. Not always, but a good portion of the time. Go ahead.
Okay. On my good list, I would like to give kudos to Lupe Fiasco.
Why?
Because
hasn't been relevant since 2006.
No. He hasn't been relevant in the game since 2006.
Lupe Fiasco is number one on your nice list.
Yeah.
Okay, number one on my nice list. I'm just going to give it to Ricky Gervais because he's Ricky Gervais. I have no reason. I just like Ricky Gervais. I didn't even fully watch Derek, his new show, but I just like Ricky Gervais.
Tiger Woods.
For what reason? Because cheating on his wife?
No.
That was last year.
No, forgetting back on his game of golf.
Next up on my nice list, I'm going to give it to Christoph Paul.
Yeah.
For being one of the most compelling guests of this holiday season.
Round of applause.
Christoph Paul.
Yeah.
I think he has a new... I think he has a new anthology coming out that's horror-themed or horror-comedy-themed. And speaking of horror, you thought there was a ghost in my house earlier this morning. The ghost of Christmas past, perhaps? Whoopee!
What?
Just throwing that out there.
What?
I don't know. You were just saying that. I mean, do you think it was Father Time or was it like the weird, creepy skeleton ghost from Scrooge? I mean...
I was talking about when I was getting the preparation stuff.
The
fun items we have on our display today.
The mics, you mean?
No.
I'm really confused by what you're talking about.
The
alcohol?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I paid for the alcohol.
No. So. When you... What? No, dude, I'm talking
about... No, I absolutely did.
No...
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about when I went upstairs to go get it for you.
Okay, what about it? How does this relate to your nice list?
What are you talking...
We're talking about naughty and nice, and you're talking about how you collected alcohol for me.
You said ghost stories, bro.
Yeah. That was an hour ago.
No, that was just a second ago.
You're out of your mind. That was like 50 minutes ago.
What?
I think you have brain cancer.
No, dude.
I think you do. Really, honestly, genuinely, I think you have lumps on your brain.
No.
Yes.
No, my brain's fine, dude.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, dude.
Anyway, on with the nice list. Go ahead.
Okay, whatever. I would have to say...
This is your last one, remember?
My little sister. Yeah, she's not a public figure.
We should add an awe track.
But she's putting in work. Like, she's trying to, like, finish up her stuff at Quincy.
Yeah, that's always fun to mess around with Brockton crackheads.
We're just concerned, Kenny, but why don't we finish up on the naughty and nice list so we don't have to have another outburst that we cannot record from you.
What outburst? Okay.
We're just worried.
No,
let's go back to the nice list. If you want to play dumb and act like you didn't just make a scene a second ago when the cameras were off.
Okay, I made a scene, my bad. You know, we didn't need that. Yeah.
Nice list, number three. Last one.
I said it already.
Your sister. Right.
Yeah.
Number three on the nice list for me is going to be Jeff Probst.
Okay, senor.
No, let's begin the naughty list now.
Okay. Could this be like a group decision, right? The first one?
What do you mean?
I think you know who we're talking about.
On the naughty list? Did I write a short story?
No.
That was vaguely about him?
Yes. Huh. We can do two, really, then. We can do two people who just, like...
That's funny. He would be on my naughty list as well.
Yeah, I really do. Like, it's just... He's still my friend.
Is he your friend? Oh, on Facebook. Like, which means virtually nothing, because I have people that I hate and people I don't even know on my Facebook.
No, like, it's just, like, I'm reading this stuff and I'm just like, damn, dude. Really? That's cool. That's nice. But no.
Number three is...
You want to say it?
Brandon Kane.
I'll clap, bro.
First up on my naughty list. Waka Flocka Flame.
Waka Flocka Porque.
Nah, I'm not explaining. I don't have to explain. I don't have to explain myself to the likes of you or anyone else.
Okay,
so why don't you begin with number two on your naughty list?
Kanye.
Kanye, yeah, Kanye's a good contender.
Yeah.
He's been a piece of shit this year.
Yeah, the book comment you told me about.
I hate the word hate. Yeah, his whole 18-page book while he's spouting off, oh yeah, I think books are so whatever he said negative.
He went off the ham with Sway.
Went off the ham.
Like MTV.
He became a vegetarian.
Like, he did?
Yeah, you just said he went off the ham.
No, like, not... He went off, like...
Ba-dum-bump.
That was funny. But no, he went crazy on Sway, dude. You don't do that to Sway.
...yourself and don't need them and do it yourself.
How, Sway?
Take a few steps back to go...
You ain't got the answers, man! You ain't got the answers!
Kanye.
You ain't got the answers!
Alright, okay.
So number two on your naughty list is, of course, Kanye West, because he is indeed a fuckboy. Number two on my naughty list.
I like that word.
Yeah.
Fuckboy.
Number two on my naughty list, Santa Claus. Because we know that Santa Claus has said some very inappropriate things. He's a racist.
All right, my last naughty list contender is...
I keep getting my finger stuck in there. I'm not going to do that anymore. That's disgusting.
My last naughty list contender is...
Number one, the most naughty of them all, keep in mind.
Oh, that motherfucker was on the tip of my tongue, dude.
Was he?
Yeah.
Did he go to the back of your throat, too? I'm saying you're a homosexual, Kenny.
That doesn't make sense, but okay. Aziz.
Ansari?
The comedian.
Aziz Ansari?
Yeah.
Why?
He's not unlocking his full potential, bro.
He isn't as funny as people make him out to be, but I do think he is starting to get better, so I don't know where you're coming from with that.
He needs to, like, step it up some, yo, like... I don't know. That's just me. Like, I'm not saying, like... It's more like... Just push. Like, come on, disease. You gotta, come on. Push.
Is he a pregnant woman? Like, what is going on here? Why? I don't understand. Wu-Tang?
Push harder. Like, work harder.
Work harder.
Work harder.
Work harder, Aziz. Yeah. I'm sorry. You're not watching this, but you should be.
This is the end. Like.
He died in that pretty
exactly,
early.
Exactly, dude. And it was just like Aziz, dog. Like, that's how they think of you. He's funny, though.
No, he's not.
I think he's funny.
His stand-up isn't funny. But number one on my naughty list this guy. Do you have any plugs?
Plugs. Life don't change. It's been revised.
I plugged that for you, but go ahead.
I was gonna say it's been revised by my amazing editor.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's been revised. You did work.
I did. A little bit. I would like to plug, of course, my book, Disorderly. You can buy that on Amazon for $11. Makes a great stocking stuffer. And buy my new book when it eventually comes out. It'll probably be out by next Christmas, Crime Wave. And that is about three teenage boys who like to kidnap dogs. And they don't really get money for it. You know, it's like a hostage situation. So they decide to break into the house of a registered sex offender. Because why? Justified burglary. That's all I'm going to say for now.
He told you that too.
You got to sit down until the end of the show. The show's not over yet.
He told you. You didn't even know it. And like, you're just like, okay, whatever.
Kenny, do you have any final words? Parting words to end the podcast with? Because we are very drunk. We are waiting for pizza. And you do indeed have heroin in your pocket right now. Is that true?
Dog food? No, that's bad. It's not right to compare people. What? Anyway, it's not right to judge people, because, like, judging does no good. If your sheet is not clean itself, and, like...
What?
If your sheet... Your life sheet? That's what... It's a term, I guess.
I don't think it's a term.
It's not a real term, but, like, it's a term that I'm using right now. Like, if your rap sheet isn't clean. If your rap sheet ain't clean, you ain't got no time to be judging people about it. I'm not talking about, like, your physical rap sheet. I'm talking about, like...
If you're obese, you can't judge people. That's what he's saying.
Whatever, I guess. Yeah.
Cool. He hates the obese.
That's 300 pounds.
Right? I'm going to leave with these parting words. Don't rape.
Merry Christmas, you guys.
Merry Christmas from Jayme and Kenney.